Hey, Got Fox here. Take a review of Deion Sanders, his power up over the full legend, not just the 90, the 94 as you see on your screen right now. So let's go through his stats here first and we'll talk about my thoughts on the card itself. I have him chemmed up more than his normal stats. We'll just run through him here, fully chemmed up, at least for what I'm using him. 94 speed, 94 acceleration, 94 agility, 92 jump, 96 play rec, 97 man, 97 zone, 77 press. So obviously the press sticks out to you, it's pretty bad. The block shed at 43, hit power at 54. Which we'll make sure to touch on. Tackling at 49, pursuit 72. He comes stock with 92 man, 92 zone. So he'll play a little bit better for me with a 97 in each stat. But as MUT Leaks said, after 90, it's diminishing returns up to 99. But 85 catching, 68 catch of traffic, 83 spec catch. I went ahead and put pick specialist on him. I don't know, for no real reason. Maybe I should put tip drill, but pick specialist, you'll see it in action here. You'll see it light up. Anyways, he's going to play on the right side of screen. Basically the right side cornerback, outside cornerback, almost the whole video here. Here is 1-on-1 getting beat deep, but able to get the SWAT animation down. Anyways, so Deion Sanders, you see him wrapping up tackling there. Like, I would expect this Deion, like in previous Maddens and MUTs and stuff, there's tip drill, could have came in handy at 21 dropping that tip. In previous MUTs, and god dang, that was an amazing play. Sorry, I keep talking about his coverage. Maybe I'll just talk about his coverage first, as he sheds a tech, sets a blocker, and gets in. Phenomenal coverage. The best cover corner you'll get, for the foreseeable future. Probably till after Christmas, right? I mean, maybe some card will come in during the Christmas promo that's better, but geez. Like, this guy flies around swatting balls, making plays for you. I absolutely adore it. But anyways, off to the run support. Like, in previous Maddens and stuff, like, run support, you'd be like, Deion's gonna get pancaked, Deion's gonna run over. That's not MUT 19. You do not see that too much out of him. He is still very amazing at tackling the runner. Maybe he will get locked up by blockers. That's one thing. On the outside, I will see Deion shed a little bit more than I expect him to, but that isn't anything like, I don't know. I think he still gets locked down by pretty decent blockers. It's inconsistent, I guess, is a good word for it. So obviously he's not like Night Train Lane back there. I do think the block shedding matters on corners, especially the impact block. I think Clint said is more important. But the hit power, the tackling, that's complete fake news. Like that, I mean, I haven't seen him get trucked once. I haven't seen him get a tackle broken once by any running backs. The only way he's getting his tackles broken or he's missing a tackle is if he gets spun out. Or like I go for a hit stick and they juke or they move out of the way of it. Like Deion Sanders is perfectly fine in run support. Like the way trucking and how nerfed it is this year, I think any corner could basically take on just about any running back, wrap him up. I've seen Champ Bailey take down Marshawn Lynch more times than I'd like to, admit. We'll get to that in the Marshawn Lynch review. But anyways, with Deion, man coverage, obviously right there, he can get burned on it. There are still routes that toast man coverage, depending on what kind of coverage you have. Press man will get beat by those unbumpables. Double moves will beat him. Well, I didn't have anybody use a double move, but I would assume it happens. I'm not so sure. There he is, 1 versus 3. Pop it right up, and nice, right to his teammate. Luckily, we took him down. So, catching 85, beautiful. The thing about this Deion is, we're going to get to some kick returns in a second. He's going to be everybody's kick returner all year. Like, it was very silly, the stats they gave him on the break tackle. He has 98 break tackle. I mean, just ridiculous. And then the kick return's great, juke's great, spin's great. Like, what's this going to do for his out-of-position card? I tried a few games with him at wide receiver. Tried the run and shoot book. It didn't go very well. Just because I didn't really have an offensive scheme, so I tried to throw it to him, force it to him. Lost a couple games, but I tried. It didn't go great. Like there he is, boom, knocked out, fumbled. So that might be an issue for you. Maybe the carrying. We'll go back to. I think this is the very next kick return for Sanders here. So off the edge, yeah. His speed is beautiful. So. I think you're going to see a lot of Deion Sanders, the power-up version, full legend version, going forward on the kick returns, because he's just great there. Obviously, you're going to take a hit. You want to hit right bumper. The 66 carrying will make you play. That's why I prefer running backs there with higher carrying to not fumble as much. But overall, like, go ahead and grab this Deion. Like, he is absolutely beautiful. I wouldn't say locked down one side of the field, but does about as good a job you can hope for. I absolutely adored the way this card played for me. He made all the plays I can really expect him to, with the exception, like, man coverage there, he is beat by 10 yards, some weird reason, because man's weird. So I don't have a top 10 list of CBs yet out less, but he will be number one with a gun right now, because he is phenomenal, does everything you want, makes plays, amazing card. Go ahead and grab him. Out of 10, I'm going to give him a 9.7. Thanks for watching Call to Action. I'll see you tomorrow.